Let's consider a few more examples to strengthen our concept of hypothesis testing. So this is our JET table. Let's go back to this problem statement to understand few more data. So let's say I have this null hypothesis which states that nu is less than or equal to 350, and my alternative hypothesis will be nu greater than 350. Now with this, can you make out that is it a one-tailed test or a two-tailed test? So with the sign of alternative hypothesis, if you remember, we can calculate that it's a upper tail test. Now, what will be in this case the critical region? Because if you remember, when I was talking about basically my two-tailed, and if I have taken the significance level as 5%, what we were doing in that case, we were looking at a 2.5% of the data from here and 2.5% data of here, right? So I was calculating the JET score for 0.975. But now, since it's a one-tailed test, so we have to consider this whole 5% here, right? So now it's not going to be 975, but instead it's going to be 950. Now let's go and check that what will be the value of JET score in this case. So if we want to calculate the JET score value, JET C value here, so this is called as JET C value, JET critical value. So in that case, I should be looking at my JET table. So let's go here and see this. And if I look at this, there is nothing called as 950, because if you see this, this is 9495 and this is 9505. So there's nothing called as 9500. So what we have to do, this is what? This is 1.64 and this is 1.65. So we need to take the average of these two to get this middle value. So let's go back. And now here we will be doing this 1.64 plus 1.65. So I will get 1.645. This is going to be JET critical value for it. Let's go to another statement. So let's say I got 1.645 as this value. And now I am basically, let's say, having this whole statement, which was earlier. Now let's say I have taken the 36 samples and I got, let's say, 370.16 value, the average for it. Now, when I'm going to calculate for this, what I'm going to do for this? So my new was 350 plus JET-C. JET-C is 1.645, which we just calculated. 90 is my standard deviation. So let's say this is also given to you. Population standard deviation is 90. And 36 is this. So we got 374.67, right? Now, what is my mean value? This. And this is my critical region, 374.67. So the mean value is lesser than basically this. That means it is in the acceptable frame, and we will be failed to reject our null hypothesis. So this is how you can perform the hypothesis testing for one-tailed test.